Hello, my name is Chris Clark, and I'm a beef specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. I would like to visit with you today just a little bit about the health management of replacement beef heifers. Just to facilitate the discussion, I've divided the early life of a heifer into these six phases. We will talk just very briefly about phase number one, which is conception to birth, and we will mention a term called fetal programming. We will then focus on points 2 through 4 and kind of take us through that early life from birth to the first pregnancy check. And then points 5 and 6 will be covered in a separate video. Health management of the replacement heifer really begins even before birth. Fetal programming is a term that you've probably heard more and more lately, and you'll probably continue to hear that term over the next few years. Basically, that's a concept that nutritional management of the pregnant cow can have a long-term impact on the health and performance of the progeny. Basically, it's just a good reminder to us that pregnant cows need to be in good body condition and they need to consume a well-balanced ration. That ration needs to include plenty of protein, plenty of energy, enough roughage for rumen health, and good vitamin and mineral supplementation. From birth to weaning, then, obviously, we start with parturition, which is the calving process. The two big things for parturition of a potential replacement heifer is to minimize dystocia and ensure consumption of colostrum. We know that calves that experience dystocia have a more difficult time regulating body temperature in that neonatal period. We also know that they are more likely to have difficulty absorbing the protective antibodies from the colostrum, and they're more at risk for infectious disease. And we know that cattle provide very little protective immunity across the placenta from mother to calf. So it's really critical that those early calves, early in life get a good dose of colostrum in order to get that protective passive immunity from the mother. From birth to weaning, then, we continue on with some early health treatments that you might want to consider. Sometime in the first couple months of life, those calves probably need a blacklegg shot or a 7-way clostridial vaccine. That's a good time also to give a pink eye vaccine if you choose to use that as a tool to help prevent pink eye, especially for spring-born calves that will go into the nursing grazing period in the summer. This is a good time to do that pink eye vaccination. External parasite control will be important as we try to minimize the effects of those face flies and horn flies. And then if you have horns to deal with, this may be a good time to do it. I think in terms of animal welfare and in terms of just minimizing stress and optimizing performance, the earlier we can get those horns taken off, the better. Pre-weaning vaccines are a very, very important part of your health management program. My recommendation is usually to administer pre-weaning shots several weeks prior to weaning, and then booster in 3 to 4 weeks following that initial dose. It's always important to follow label directions, especially if you're using modified live virus vaccines. There is some risk of causing fertility problems and abortion in pregnant cows when you administer those vaccines to calves that are nursing pregnant cows. Usually, if you have those cows on a good vaccine regimen with modified live viruses, there's very little risk. But that's where it becomes important to follow those label instructions. The modified live virus would be my recommendation just because it gets a little better immunity, a little stronger immunity. And you would want to include these 4 viruses. Usually they're combined in a 4-way vaccine, IBR, BVD, BRSV, and PI3. Additional pre-weaning vaccines would include a booster of your 7-way clostridial shot or your blackleg vaccine. You might also want to vaccinate for Histophilus somni, Mannheimia hemolytica, and Pasteurella multocida. For replacement heifers, I would still recommend vaccinating for brucellosis. Remember that this must be done by an accredited veterinarian. It has to be done when heifers are between 4 and 12 months of age, and vaccinated heifers need to be properly identified with an official calf-lid vaccinate tag, which is the orange steel tag seen in these heifers in the picture, and also a tattoo, all that regulatory information and tracking information needs to go in the right ear. Other pre-weaning health considerations would include parasite control. Young heifers can come off of pasture having a pretty significant worm burden following summer grazing, so deworming can really help improve their overall health and performance. And then the weaning process is definitely a stressful time for a calf. And I think it's beneficial to minimize the stress of weaning as much as possible. It might be worth taking a look at some low-stress weaning techniques like fence line weaning, day weaning, two-step weaning, where you use the plastic nose tags to prevent nursing, and then give them a few days with the mothers while they're not able to nurse, and then kind of follow up with separation from the dam. Remember that ration changes are a big part of this, and these cattle are going to be changing from a primarily forage-based and milk-based diet to probably a concentrate-based diet. We want to make those changes very gradually, and throughout the process we want to make sure that we offer, again, plenty of energy, plenty of protein, enough roughage to keep that rumen functioning well, and then good vitamin and mineral supplementation. We also want to watch closely for bovine respiratory disease during the weaning process. We know that stress suppresses the immune system, and the most common manifestation of that, the most common disease secondary to a suppressed immune system in cattle, would be pneumonia or bovine respiratory disease complex. Weaning to breeding is a phase where heifers should receive a modified live booster that includes IBR and BVD, and we want to do this 30 to 60 days prior to breeding. The modified live vaccines can cause a transitory infertility and should not be given less than 30 days before breeding. I would also include a leptovibrio vaccine, probably also given 30 to 60 days pre-breeding. When it comes to the lepto shot, over the last several years we've started to include leptohargobovis into our vaccines more and more, and that is the host-adapted strain that cattle can carry as the maintenance host, and infected cattle can actually shed that in their urine for several months after an infection. So I would try to include leptohargobovis into your vaccine regimen. There are a few products out there now that have added leptohargobovis onto the traditional five-way lepto vaccine. Just another quick note there on terminology, many producers, and myself included, still refer to those shots as leptovibrio shots. A vibrio actually refers to an organism called Campylobacter fetus. Some other considerations that you might want to think about for yearling heifers would include body condition scoring, pelvic measuring, and reproductive tract scoring. These are things that can just kind of help in the selection process and can help us make sure that we are selecting for easy doing, easy fleshing heifers, heifers that are going to be pubertal and cycling and fertile when it comes time for that first breeding, and so that we're selecting heifers that have adequately sized pelvises to deliver calves in the future. Breeding to pregnancy check would include some parasite control, especially if we're breeding for spring calves. We're going to breed probably in early summer, and we're going to have to deal with both internal and external parasites through that grazing period. Ideally, we breed those heifers a little bit early and try to make their calving window approximately 1 month prior to the calving window for your mature cows. We want to use a calving ease bull, and we want to preg check sometime in the early to mid gestation, so that we can make some good decisions about marketing the cattle that didn't settle. And finally, I would make a note about biosecurity. It's very important to implement some type of biosecurity program to minimize the risk of disease transmission. These are just a few examples of things you can do. Posting a sign for visitors to check in before getting onto the farm. Quarantine new animals for approximately 3 weeks and watch for signs of illness. Buy virgin bulls or bulls that have been tested negative for Trichomonas fetus, and control insects and rodents and other potential vectors. Again, those are just examples, and there's probably many more things that we could add to that list to protect your herd from disease. Just some additional resources for you. First and foremost, I would mention your local veterinarian. It's very important that you establish a veterinary client-patient relationship with a veterinarian that you trust. So that you have someone available to answer your questions and someone available that you can call when emergencies happen. I would also suggest getting to know your regional extension beef specialist. There are 6 of us out in the field across the state, and there are some additional specialists on campus, and we're all more than willing to help with any questions you may have. Usually if we don't know the answer, we can find someone who does, and we can get you to some really good resources in most cases. I also listed a couple websites there, the Iowa Beef Center website and the BDPAM website from the College of Veterinary Medicine, have lots and lots of good information. There's also the Applied Reproductive Strategies website listed. They have a lot of good information posted specifically on reproduction and breeding. And then the final link there, or the final website there, will take you to a publication from the Midwest Planning Services called Cow-Calf Production in the U.S. Corn Belt. And that's a pretty comprehensive, just broad publication with lots of great information. I think it's available for $40 at that website. Finally, just a special thank you to Matthew Eddy from Southeast Polk High School and Ankeman Ranch in Miami, Oklahoma, for providing me with some pictures to use for our presentation. Thank you very much for taking the time to view this video, and good luck with your heifer development.